Michael Brown, Eric Garner, Oscar Grant, Marlene Pinnick are just examples of the kind of brutality that exists in this country against African-American citizens by the police. I've been involved in many of these cases, and it's outrageous to see and hear and feel what happens to people when they have been falsely arrested, illegally detained, assaulted, beaten, arms broken, legs broken, and going to jail for crimes they have not committed. You know, it's dangerous out here dealing with the police. I would suggest that you understand what your rights are. I've told you many times, but you ought to know that you always should keep your hands in a place where they can be seen. Do not fight with the police. Do not run from the police. Do not have any type of weapons. Make sure you protect yourself, de-escalate situation, and understand that police have guns and they will use them against you, and they will lie and make false statements. We in this country must do something about it. Remember that the lives that have been lost are important lives, and they should not have been lost in vain. And each of us have a responsibility to come forward and take some action against this. The time has come for all of us. The economic community, the business community, the social community, the faith community all need to stand up together and protest this type of conduct that is occurring against the African American community. So I call upon everyone to join with us to fight this misconduct. We must, as a community, come together and stand against police brutality. The date is November 28th. It's important to let the entire country know that police brutality is a wrong. It has a negative impact upon all communities, and we should do something to stop it from occurring right now.